What's new in Adobe Illustrator CC 2019? Hello, what's up guys? Welcome to my YouTube channel DigitalCreations, and today in this video tutorial, we are going to learn the new latest feature of Adobe Illustrator CC 2019. So let's get started. Before starting this video tutorial, don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel DigitalCreations and hit the bell icon so you never miss my new latest uploads. So let's get started. The new latest feature of Adobe Illustrator CC 2019 is the global editing. Our design contains multiple copies of similar objects you see in this artwork, like logos, icons, and different shapes. So if we need to edit all at once, so we don't need to edit all objects one by one. So just go to global editing option and edit all objects in one step. It is super easy. So I'm just going to select this logo. Right side in the properties panel, here is the option of global editing. So we can change the color of this logo, and to show you how it works. So downside you see start global edit. I'm just going to select it. Further properties, and here I'm just going to match the appearance of the object and select all artboard and start global edit, and I'm going to change the color a little bit, background of this logo. And guys, you see it edits all objects in one step, and it is super easy. And when you are working to show the business identity, you are designing different letterhead flyers and same things in different artboards, and the object is same, so you can globally edit the same similar objects in one step. The new latest feature of Illustrator CC 2019 is Freeform Gradient tool. Now, before we use a radial and linear gradients, and this is the new feature of Freeform Gradients to create, to give us a flexibility to create a colored stops at anywhere in our artwork or object. So I'm just going to select my object, and here is the option of Freeform Gradient. I'm going to select it. To show you the new feature of Freeform Gradient tool. So here I'm just going to select the object of Freeform Gradient. Now guys, you see when I select this object, this Freeform Gradient option, there are two circles, stops here, color stops here. So we can double click here and change the color. I'm just going to double click here and change the color, depend on where we want to set. Guys, you see it is much easy to create flexible colors, and you see we can move it around. And we can add double click here anywhere, and we can add further circles to add different colors in a different place. So you see in the properties, there are two types of freeform gradients options here. Line, this mode is used to shade area around the line. And endpoints, with this mode is used to shade the area around the color stops. So I'm just going to check the line option. Just click here and just draw a line. You see guys, this is very easy to create a freeform gradient with the help of line mode. So it shades the area around a line, you see. It is much easy and super fast to create a flexible, nice gradient in your artworks. So this tool is amazing, and I really like this to create beautiful illustrations, to fill gradients in a very easy way. We can edit this gradient further. So here is the options, so you can edit it in points or lines, whether you want it. Another very exciting feature is the visual font browsing option. So in this artwork, I'm just going to show you so we can browse fonts faster than before. So I'm just going to select this tags. I'm just going to short it to show you and scale it a little bit down to show you how it's work. The new latest feature of Adobe Illustrator CC 2019 visual font browsing. So I'm just going to select it, and in the character panel, I'm just going to show you, just click here, and here guys, you see we can browse different fonts, and to show to your clients, it is in a very super easy way. So the character panels now includes new options to filter your fonts, and you can save your fonts and to add to favorites to choose in your future further use. So you see here, you will find it your and here further classification, you can filter your fonts like different letters here. So, and much options here, and you can download your Adobe fonts. So different you can pay the different fonts here, so you can find it here, find more, and filters the Adobe fonts from here as well. In Adobe Illustrator CC 2019, the new enhanced feature, which is I really like it, which is faster zoom option. Before we zoom, we use a short key in the toolbar. We found a zoom tool, and short key is Z, and you see zoom performance in Adobe Illustrator CC 2019 has been much improved for vector images, and whether it is raster images. And you see in this artwork, the short key is to zoom is Control minus in Windows, and you see this, the zoom performance is much better than before. So I'm going to show you just import this picture to show you the raster raster images, this raster image, and to show you the zoom performance. So you see it is much faster than before. Look at this, and very smoothly we zoom the raster image or vector image in Adobe Illustrator CC 2019. Much improved performance in zoom tool. Another new feature of Adobe Illustrator CC 2019 is the new presentation mode. So in presentation mode, the artboard display as a slideshow, so we can view our artwork in a presentation mode. So here in the toolbar panel, you see the just click here, and we find the presentation mode here, and the short key is Shift plus F in Windows. And guys, you see in this way very easily we see our artboards in a slideshow mode. So this feature is very exciting to show your artwork to your client in a full screen mode. And we can exit it by pressing the escape key in the keyboard in Windows. So again, we just check a click here in the toolbar panel, and before we have these options, but this presentation mode is available, and it is very good, and I really like this because if you're suddenly your client come and they want to show, you want to share your artworks in a slideshow mode, in a very easy way. Another new feature of Adobe Illustrator CC 2019 is content-aware crop, so we can crop images in a very easy way in Adobe Illustrator CC 2019. And content-aware crop feature is powered by Adobe Sensei, intelligently identifies visually significant portion of the image, so you can find it in a view or crop image, and you can find in the content bar as well. So here you see it is automatically identifies the portion, significant portion of the object of the image, so we can crop it easily, this picture, this image, and hit apply. So guys, before we have problems in, you know, if we are designing some flyers and if you want to use images in Illustrator, so we can cut it, we create different way to cut this picture, but in this new feature we just cut it and just directly paste this picture in our flyers or in our design. Any illustration we made it, and we just put it, just crop it picture, and just put it directly in your artwork. Another exciting feature of Adobe Illustrator CC 2019, which is the trim view mode. So in this mode we can preview our design without guides or elements or grids that or any elements that enter beyond the edge of the artboards. So you see this artwork is beyond the beyond the edges. So I'm just going to select the view and trim view option, select the trim view options, and here we can preview our design without any further elements that entered beyond the edges. So all the non-printing objects can be hidden from the canvas you see here, and I really like this option. So to show your artwork to your clients, and it is super easy. The new puppet wrap tool with new enhancement, and in Illustrator it automatically identifies the optional area to transform and automatically appends to the object. So I'm just going to select this this logo, and to show you the new enhanced puppet wrap tool, I'm just going to select it. I'm just going to select this logo and select the puppet wrap tool in under the toolbar panel, and guys, you see it's automatically transformed to add pins, so we can change the object significantly and intelligently. It adds the pin, the different identifies the optional area, so we can move it.
PremiumBeat.com.
The new customizable toolbar options, so we can create our custom toolbars. So in the toolbar panel you see there are three dots ellipse, so we can edit the toolbar, so we can add, remove, group or reorder tools according to our work. So I'm just going to click here to show you the new customizable toolbar option, and this new all tools options available here, and further click here. I'm just going to switch to advanced. There are two types of toolbars, advanced and basics. So by default is basics available, and we can switch to advanced as well, and we can create a new toolbar according to our work. So let me show you to I'm just going to select some tools, text tools to insert in our toolbar. So I just drag, and you see this plus sign, this drop here in the toolbar. So when you click here and drag and drop the tools, so just release the mouse and I'm just going to drop it this vertical area tool, vertical type tool and touch type tool in the text tool group. And here just to show you, this are these text tools are further text tools are included in this toolbar. So now guys, upper side we just we can downside, you see, to show options, show and hide options. So we'll click to show the coloring controls, and you can hide it just by clicking the different controls and different options. So upside you see the new toolbar option, just going to click it to create a new toolbar, and this dialog box is open, and here I'm just going to name the new artwork the toolbar name and hit OK. And guys, you see the new toolbar is open. So it is a very easy way, so you can customize toolbars according to your work, and so you can add, remove groups or reorder your different tools in a very easy way to access different tools for your work. Now guys, in the end, if you like my video, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel Digital Creations.